Hello guys, you're welcome once more. Today we'll be talking about a topic which is very, very interesting, especially to me, and I hope I'm able to make you find interest in it. Trigonometry. Trigonometry to me is like you're giving buildings and you're asked to find the type of blocks which were used to make the buildings. Like in biology, they are like what monomers are used to make polymers and all this stuff. So it's just to identify what blocks are used to come up with all those long and complicated equations. Trigonometry is used in real life. Let me see, where are they applied on? Yes, the one which you see every day. When you're passing by the road and you see the surveyors with a certain apparatus, they are trying to measure the length of how the road should be, or measure the hills, measure the structure. Those equipment have inputs of trigonometry functions in such a way that the equipment takes the data sends which they receive. When they measure, they take the data and they carry out all the functions inside what we are supposed to calculate, and they give you now what you need. We also see trigonometry used in the calculation of we have this equipment, sextants, which is used in ships. When they are approaching the shore, they use it and it tells them how far the shore is. Or the people ashore can predict how far a certain ship is used to measure distances. Trigonometry is just a relationship between length and height. Length, height, and angles. It's used to calculate the mountains, like our Mount Faku. It's been clear they didn't stand at the foot of the mountain with a meter and go right up there and tell us that Mount Faku is 4,000 kilometers high. No, they had to use those equipments which calculated and told us that that is the height of the mountain. So trigonometry is very, very important if you want to take up a career in science, especially if you're doing geology, you want to be an architect, or trigonometry is very, very important. Its importance cannot be overemphasized. So those are the various places where we'll find trigonometry after your classroom. Trigonometry, the secret about trigonometry which saved me was knowing the trigonometry identities. Once as you know the identities, which are the building blocks of all the equations, you would easily solve any equation thrown at you. So we'll begin by showing you the equations, and I insist the best way to master the trigonometric identities is by solving questions daily. When you solve daily, the questions will become like how well you know the names of your friends, you know the names of, because there are people you contact every day. So if you solve trigonometric questions every day, trust me, you will know the identities. Okay, so let's begin by identifying those trigonometric identities. Trigonometric identities are the building blocks of every trigonometric question. So identifying your trigonometric identities, it's the first rule in demystifying any question which is put across to you. So here are the various trigonometric identities which are used most of the time. Sine theta equals to 1 on cosec theta. Tan theta equals to sine theta on cos theta. Cos theta is 1 on sec theta. Tan theta is 1 on cos theta. Cos theta is cos theta on sine theta. The best way to master this is to always solve trigonometric questions. You solve it daily and you master it just as well as you master the names of all your friends and all your classmates. One very, very important equation in trigonometry which we are to master is sine squared theta plus cos squared theta equals to 1. This is a formula which will come across almost every time. Its importance cannot be overemphasized. So make sure you master the sine squared theta plus cos squared theta equals to 1. Okay, let's take a GCE type question. We have cos to the power 4 theta
minus sine to the power 4 theta all on cos square theta equal to 1 minus tan square theta. Prove this. So normally when you have a question like this, what you do is you have to choose one side because you have to prove the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. So when you look at it and you look at the one which is much more complicated, which you can easily break down, and that's the one you choose. So looking at this, we have cos to the fourth power, and it's a little bit complicated here. So we'll choose to break down the left hand side. So the left hand side can be written as cos 4 theta minus sine to the 4 theta on cos square theta. Now here, your knowledge of algebraic identities will help you. You know, algebraic identities, we have, as an aside, we have a plus b squared equals to a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. These are your algebraic identities. We also have a squared minus b squared is equal to a minus b, a plus b. So using this identity, we can demystify this a little. So when we come here, this cos 4 theta, we can write it as cos squared theta, all squared, minus sine squared theta, all squared. Because when we open the brackets, this comes by this, so it will still be cos 4 theta. So this has simply been represented by this, divided by cos squared theta. This can furthermore be broken down if we use this our formula. So this will be a squared and this will be b squared. So we have a minus b. So that's cos squared theta minus sine squared theta into a plus b into cos squared theta plus sine squared theta all over cos squared theta. And now when you look at this, there is one formula which we, one identity which we recognize already, which we have talked about earlier. Cos squared theta plus sine squared theta, we have this to be 1. So we can represent this as 1, and 1 multiplied by this will still give it. So we have, it becomes cos squared theta minus sine squared theta all into cos squared theta. Now it's simple. This can also be written as, since they have the common denominator, we can break it down. We have cos squared theta divided by cos squared theta minus sine squared theta into, divided by cos squared theta, sorry. So cos squared theta into cos squared theta gives 1 minus sine squared theta on cos squared theta. Sine theta on cos theta is tan. So since the powers are similar, so it will be tan squared theta. And this is equal to our right hand side. So we can see we've proven that this is equal to this. Second question. Show that sine theta plus cos theta all squared equal to 1 plus 2 sine theta cos theta. So here you can choose either the left hand side or the right hand side to simplify. But when you see already like this, this is already a little bit simple. This looks complicated, so I think it's easier to simplify this one. So now we have to open the brackets. You remember your algebraic identities, which say a plus b all squared, it's a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. Applying this here, we simply have sine theta plus cos theta all squared will be sine squared theta plus 2 sine theta cos theta cos theta plus b squared, which is cos squared theta plus cos squared theta. Now, we see already an identity. I hope you've seen it also like me. We have sine squared theta here, we have cos squared theta here, and it's an additional sign. So we can bring it closer. We have sine squared theta plus cos squared theta plus 2 sine theta cos theta. Sine squared theta plus cos squared theta is 1. So this is 1 plus 2 sine theta cos theta, which is equal to the right hand side. 1 plus 2 sine theta cos theta, 1 plus 2 sine theta cos theta. So we've proven sine theta plus cos theta all squared equals to 1 plus 2 sine theta cos theta. Now before we end this, the last advice I have to give, and which I insist on, is trigonometry is very, very interesting. It's a game. So what I advise you to do is always solve. Keep on solving every time. Use it for fun. Solve it for fun. Forget about the examinations. Solve for fun and you will enjoy it. Just play with the trig identities. Play with the formulas and you will discover yourself that you've mastered the identities very, very well. That's the best way to master the identities. Solve continuously. Take up the challenge to solve one question every day, one question every day, and you discover you know the trigonometric identities to your fingertips. So thank you very much, and we'll be waiting to hear from you guys about what problems you have, and we are here. Thank you very much. Stay tuned.